Welcome to our economics class. I am Chinmay Hegde. Yeah, this is the subject Karnataka economy. In recent our classes, we discuss about the development of agriculture in Karnataka, your agriculture and allied activities in Karnataka. In terms of agriculture and allied activities, in our state, we practice different types of agri-related activities, which includes beekeeping, sericulture, animal husbandry or livestock farming, and some other activities. Here the major agricultural activities include cultivation, that includes agricultural activity, and also horticultural activities. Other than these two activities, some other agri-related activities which are more important in terms of earnings in agricultural activity, that means share of agricultural sector income in our GDP or GSDP, and also the occupational structure that indicates the employment generation with agricultural sector and that related activities sectors. Here today's topic is sericulture and sericulture industry in Karnataka. Here sericulture is one of the part of agriculture and it includes production of silk and related activities. Here sericulture is just only the production of silk and their related activities. Like sericulture is one of the major employment generating sector in the state and its growth has immense employment generation potential, and particularly in rural Karnataka. In rural area, sericulture is one of the alternate employment source. Here, in terms of area and production of sericulture activity, the basic source of sericulture is mulberry leaves cultivation, mulberry cultivation. Here in terms of mulberry cultivation, the area under mulberry cultivation in the state was about 97,196 hectares at the end of November 2017. During 2016 and 17, mulberry silk production in Karnataka was 9,571 metric tons. Here 9,500 metric tons, it was silk production in Karnataka during 2016 and 17. And just the overall scenario about the silk industry in Karnataka in terms of their area, production and their employment. There is the area under mulberry cultivation is 91.49 thousand hectares and the production of cocoons 68.381 thousand metric tons, and the quantum of cocoons marketed, the marketed silk, that means that is 47.030 thousand metric tons, and raw silk production was 9.571 thousand metric tons. The employment structure in this industry, sericulture activities, it provides employment about 11.87 lakh people, 87 lakh employment generation, 11.87 lakh employment generation under sericulture industry in Karnataka, in our state. And then the some policies for sericulture activity, that to bring in more number of farmers under the sericulture umbrella, various programs are implemented by our state government and also central government. to encourage the stakeholders providing seed coupon bonus or incentives and other chowki cost and raw material, so raw silk incentives here, which include incentives for mulberry cultivation and cocoon production and their infrastructural developments. Here, sericulturists are also provided financial assistance for infrastructure development, that is construction of rearing house, establishment of chowki rearing centers, drip irrigation, etc., and also establish automatic reeling machines, multi-end reeling machines and cottages, etc., and also increase in the mulberry area, confirm that it facts that sericulture is the only sustainable vocation which can generate more income and employment in rural life, rural area. And the new sericulture programs during 2017 and 18, here in that first one is to establish silkworm egg or chowki quality control authority to ensure the quality control in development of silk industries. And the second one, to provide financial assistance to training for a period of 1 month in post-cocoon activities under Entrepreneurs Development Program conducted by the Central Silk Board, to establish Sericulture Training Institute in Hassan District to impart training to farmers and other departmental employees. And next one, a grant of 5 crore rupees will be provided to Karnataka Silk Industries Corporation to establish second composite weaving factory in the premises of Mysore Silk Weaving Factory. So these are the recent some programs and policies about development of sericulture industry in Karnataka. And very importantly, Karnataka has separate one establishment for the development of sericulture industry, the Karnataka Silk Marketing Board, Karnataka Silk Marketing Board Limited. The Karnataka Silk Marketing Board Limited, promoted by the government of Karnataka, and it was established in 1979. This was done with the intention of stabilizing the prices of silk yarn. During 2016 and 17, the company has made turnover of ₹848.842 lakhs, and the board is primarily discharging the function of price stabilization of silk yarn, which is generally a non-profitable proposition. So this is the brief introduction about Karnataka Silk Marketing Board. Basically, this organization was established only for stabilization of silk prices, and that stabilization of silk prices, which promotes or which is favorable for marketing of silk yarn and regular sustainable income for producers, silk producers, that means farmers. See, these are the some brief information about sericulture industry in Karnataka. Okay, thank you.